Hi friends, welcome back to VLSIFAB. Today I am going to discuss about how to analyze the timing reports. Why I have chosen this topic? Because many of you know the theoretical terms like skew, uncertainty, but when we need to relate it with practical things, sometimes people may get confused. So in this video, I have tried to analyze this setup timing report. In case you like the video, please comment it, and those who are new, please subscribe it. So let's start the video without wasting time. So before going to analyze the setup time, we must know on which part of the block we are going to do the timing analysis. From block point of view, there are total 4 different types of path available. I have marked it with 1, 2, 3 and 4. So one is input to reg, second is reg to reg, third is reg to out, and fourth is feed through. So input to reg means input port to the input of the resistors. Reg to reg means output of the reg to input of the reg, and reg to out means output of the resistors to the output port, and feed through means the input port to the output port. So while doing setup or hold in block point of view, we are concerned about only reg to reg paths, because input to reg and reg to out will be handled by the top level guy. So guys, please watch till last. At the end of the video, I hope you will be able to analyze the setup timing reports for reg to reg path. As you know, for analysis of setup time, we have to consider maximum delay along the data path and minimum delay along the clock path. So in a timing report, basically it will all about launch path for the data path and the capture path, that is clock path in this case. So but before going to analysis timing report, we should be familiar with few terms which I will discuss in the upcoming slides, and those terms which are frequently used in the timing reports. And to know more, please refer previous videos of VLSIFAB, like timing constraints, ST analysis using PT. So all those videos already given in the VLSIFAB channel. You can please explore it. A setup and a hold slack is defined as the difference between the data required time and the data arrival time. So setup slack is equals to data required time minus data arrival time. And a positive slack means design is working at the specified frequency and it has some more margin as well. Zero setup slack specifies design is exactly working at the specified frequency and there is no margin available. Negative setup slack implies that design doesn't achieve the constrained frequency and timing. This is called setup violation. So definition of clock latency or clock insertion delay. So like in sequential design, each timing path is triggered by a clock signal that originates from a source. The flops being triggered by the clock signal are known as sinks for the clock. So in general, clock latency is defined as the amount of time taken by the clock signal in traveling from its source to the sinks. So clock latency comprises of two components, clock source latency and the clock network latency. So clock network latency or clock network delay is defined as the time taken by the clock signal in traversing from clock definition point to the sinks of the clock. Thus, each sinks of the clock has a different network latency. So the important term that is related with timing path analysis is CPPR, that is common path pessimism removal. So common path pessimism arises when the launching and capturing clocks share a common path. The difference between the maximum delay and minimum delay of this common clock path segment is called the common path pessimism. So EDA tool take care of this using common path pessimism removal, that is CPPR. So these are the few symbols used in timing report. So the typical symbols shown in the prime time timing reports are defined. Like R means these are the in the path column for the rising edge of the signal. Same way F means in the path column for the falling edge of the signal. So these are the few frequently used like symbols that we will see in the timing report. So this is a full timing report of prime time, that is from Synopsys. So in the upcoming slides I will going to discuss all the terms and all the things part wise. I have categorized into three parts, and as you can see in the timing report, like the other terms that I have already discussed, like start point, end point, data arrival time, then clock network delay, clock reconvergence, pessimism, library setup, data, so slack. So these are the terms you have to be familiar with it before going to analyze the timing report. So guys, if you have not gone through these terms properly, so I will advise you first go through this term, then it will be easier for you to understand the timing report. So here starts the timing report analysis. So whenever we do STA, it always in respect to two flops. One is launching flop and another is capturing flop. In our case, number one is launching flop and number two is capturing flop. So launching flop means start points and capturing flop means end points. So here from timing diagram, you can see QR underscore TMP is flip-flop 1, FF1, and QR is FF2, flip-flop 2. So when it's path type is max, that means we are going to analyze this setup. And also you can see rising edge triggered flip-flop clocked by CLK. That means clock is positive edge triggered and clock name is CLK. So this is continuation of timing report. And for viewer readability, I have marked numbers against each line number. And also in diagram, I have marked the same. From 3 to 10, this calculation is for data arrival time. And from 11 to 7, it's about data required time. So in the report, INCR, that is incremental delay. As we started with data arrival time, it starts from clock port. So in 4, you can see number 4, it's clock network delay. That is 0.204 delay from clock port to clock pin of flip-flop 1. Then in 6, 0.146 delay has been added. That is clock to Q delay. In 7 and 8, 0.73 and 0.166 delay value has been added. In that is for buffer. And in 9, 0.026 delay has been added up to D point. So that this 0.026 is the wire delay. So the data arrival time is finally 0.614. So from 11 to 17, it's about the data required time. As setup, we check in the next clock edge. So you can see in 11, there is a value 6.510. This is nothing but the clock period of the clock CLK. So in 12, clock network delay has been added. That means delay from the clock port to CLK pin of the FF2 for that 0.321. Then in 13, we add the clock reconvergence pessimism value, that is 0.003. And in 12, it's also showing clock is propagated. For that, clock is not ideal. That means this report is of CTS or after CTS stage. Then in 14, we subtract uncertainty value. Uncertainty is a combination of jitter, margin and skew. But as clock is already propagated, we got the original skew value. So here in this uncertainty value, skew is not included. So to reach the clock to the clock pin of flip-flop 2, FF2, it will take 6.675. So every flip-flop has its own predefined setup and hold values for it. So we need to subtract it to get the final data required time. So calculating the slack for the data required minus data arrival, it's coming positive. So if slack is positive, that means this will work in the given frequency. So these are the few commands that we used in timing analysis in PT, prime time. So like as you have seen, what are the things that are needed in a timing analysis, like skew, uncertainty, then slack. So these things we need to check by using these commands. So guys, if you have liked this video, so please comment in the comment section, and I will try to make a similar kind of video for hold analysis also. So guys, those who are new, I will request you to subscribe the channel for getting all the videos regularly, and those who are already a subscriber, please like, share into VLSIFAB. Thank you.